Next, write down nomenclature of alkanes. So in the nomenclature, we have to follow the rules. Okay, there is three, four common rules we have, which is not true for all kinds of compounds.
Sir, between alkane and alkene, which is more stable?
That we cannot say.
But alkene has a double bond. Right?
So what? See, we cannot compare it this way. It's like, say, between you and you, who is more powerful? Say something like that. Okay. So but you can say here, it's possible. But two compounds you are comparing, right? One is unsaturated compound, and other one is saturated compound. Double bond wala formula we use when we have RS of same structure. These two are completely different. One is alkene, other one is alkyne. These two are completely different, right? So we cannot compare the stability here. But if carbon-carbon bond has double bond characteristics, the bond strength will be what? More. So if you can say this thing, if this molecule we have, ethane and ethene, what we can say? We can say which one of these two carbon-carbon bond is stronger, that we can say. Overall molecule we cannot compare, right? Obviously this is double bond, this one is stronger than this, okay, bond length is stronger, okay? So that double bond, all those structure or the rules that we use only for what? Only for RS of same molecule, okay? Two different molecule RS we cannot compare by those 8 or 9 rule that we have discussed in stability of various resonating structure, right? Nomenclature of alkanes, like I said, we have to follow the rules into this. What is the rule number 1? Write down nomenclature of alkanes. See, mainly we'll see questions into this. With questions only you'll understand the rule. Directly if you go through the rules, you won't understand like how to, you know, solve the questions and look at the important things which is there or not, right? So first rule write down. The first rule is select the longest carbon chain. Select the longest carbon chain . This is known as the parent chain, principal carbon chain or parent chain. Second rule number 2.
So all these rules are in order, we have to do it in order.
Yes, rule number 2. If the two carbon chain in a compound, have equal number of carbon atoms, then the carbon chain which has more number of locants or substituents, then the carbon chain which has more number of substituents is the parent chain. Okay, this is example you see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. In this one. Which one is the parent chain in this?
Right.
See, if you go this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So two carbon chain has equal number of carbon atoms, right? So if you select this as the parent chain, then what happens? It has only one substituent, right? Substituent is the branch that is present in the parent chain. So this chain has only one substituent. But if you select this one as the parent chain, so this has three substituents. One is this, another one is this, and another one is this. So this is the correct, correct chain will be this one, parent chain. Okay? Now when you select the parent chain, you have to number the carbon atom. Numbering should be done after this. Okay? And numbering means what? We can start the numbering either from this side or this side. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that. Okay, so this numbering should be done in such a way so that the locants or substituents gets least possible number. Okay, that is rule number 3. The next rule write down.
So what if you have two chains that are the same length and there's the same number of branches?
Then we'll see the sum of locates. We'll discuss that. This example we'll discuss that. Okay. Write down rule number 3. Numbering should be done in such a way. Numbering should be done in such a way so that the substituents gets least possible number. Least possible number. This is known as lowest set of locants rule. Lowest set of locants rule. Next line, if the carbon chain contains more than one substituents, the carbon chain contains more than one substituents, then the sum of locants, then the sum of locants should be minimum. Next rule. All the substituents must be written in alphabetical sequence. Alphabetical sequence. Okay? Suppose we have this example. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And here one carbon atom is present. Yes.
So if you have, let's say, you look at the branches, both the branches have equal length and equal number of substituents.
I'll come to that. We'll see some of locants. Okay, we'll see examples. Okay, have patience. Half an hour, ruko, sab kuch clear ho jayega. Okay, we'll do the examples. You'll understand. Okay. So this is a compound here. So obviously the longest chain is what? Longest chain is this one, right? Now we can start numbering from this side or this side. Two possibility we have. If you start from this side, the numbering will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, right? So the position of this locant is third position, right? If you start from the other side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, right? So since this numbering gives the least possible number to this carbon atom which has the locants, that's why the correct numbering will be this one. This is wrong. Okay? This is one thing. Understood? What is the name of this compound? 3-methyl hexane. This one you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here we have one carbon and here we have two carbons. If you change the molecule, then the thing will be different, right? So,
Number 4.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter what it is. So, you can choose it from any side if there are another carbon in there.
You're saying one carbon atom here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Then it doesn't matter
which side. Then both. See, in this case, we'll see that's what I am taking in this example. You see, I'll do this and then we'll come back to this, okay? So, in this one, we have to start numbering from this side. Yeah. Any confusion?
No.
Right? If you start from this side, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now you see we have two substituents present. Okay? So this side, if you do the numbering, then the sum is what? Sum is 5. 2 plus 3 is 5. This side, if you do the sum, is what? 5 plus 4 is 9. Right? So we'll follow the lowest sum of locants. This 2 gives 5, this 2 gives 9, so this one is wrong, this one is right. Okay, so if we have more than one substituents, then we'll follow the lowest sum of locants rule. When we have only one substituent present, then we'll give the least possible number, lowest set of locations to be called it as. Now, if you attach one carbon here, then 3 and 4 and 3 and 4. Anyway, if you do, you'll get the same answer. Okay? Understood? This one you see? 1, 2, 3, 4. Here I attach bromine, chlorine. 1, 2, 3, 4. Bromine, chlorine. This one. What is the correct numbering?
1, 2, 3, 4.
Right? If you start from this side, then the position will be third and fourth. Here it is first and second. So lowest sum of locations. If you start from this side, 1, 2, 3, 4. If you start from this side, 1, 2, 3, 4. Which one is correct in this one? In this one, you see, the difference is what? 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Here you see the sum of locants in both numbering is different. This side you are getting 3, right? Here it is 3, and here it is 7. So we'll follow the lowest sum of locants rule. The correct numbering is this one. This is wrong, right? Now in this one, the sum of locants are same. 2 plus 3 is 5, 2 plus 3 is 5. Okay, so now in this case, we'll give the least possible number to the substituents which comes alphabetically first. Okay, that is bromine, bromo, right? It is chloro. So the correct one is this one, this is wrong. Answer will be 2 bromo, 3 chloro, butane. Is it clear? Is it clear? These 3-4 rules are clear, no? Okay. So this is the rule. It is common for all the compounds, whether it is alkane, alkene, or any functional group is present. Only few things you have to keep in mind, that where we should give the more priority to which of the functional group, right? But this 3-4 rules that we have discussed, it is common for all the compounds. Now I'll give you some example. Write down the name of these compounds. The first one is
I'm going to go to the next one.
Di, tri, tetra will take in alphabetical sequence if the complex, if the substituents is complex. In case of complex substituent, for simple substituents you won't take. What is complex? We'll discuss. Let's see what this is.
So which gets preference is one
alphabetical. So ethyl and chloro will write first.
Sir, for the fourth one, can we write 2, 2, 3?
No. Longest chain first you select.
Yeah. Oh, the third one is
here, if you number from this one, then we have 2, 2 dimethyl. And this one will be 4th, right? Third. If you do from this side, 2 chloro and 3, 3 dimethyl. Sum of tokens, if you do numbering this way, will be more. That's why we'll follow this way. Okay. Done.
So, this entire chapter like this will get harder.
Just you have to follow the rules.
So, was it the 7? Huh? Was it the 7?
7 is
happening.
Yeah.
Where did you
go to
7?
7. The numbers are separated by comma. Numbers and letters separated by dash. And there should be no space in the way. No space. Done. The longest chain is what? 1, 2 and 3, right? So name of this will be what? 2, 2, 2 dimethyl propane. Okay? Now listen to one thing, that these numbers are separated by comma always. Okay? You cannot write down dash here. Numbers and letters are separated by dash and there should be no space in between. Okay? If you do not follow this, you'll get 0 marks in the exam. Okay? However, in the...
So between dimethyl and propane
also? No. No space. Okay? So 2, 2 dimethyl propane. The longest chain is what? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So what we can write? 3, 3, and third position we have ethyl group. 1 and 2 carbon, right? So ethyl. 1 and 2 carbon, ethyl. So 3, 3, diethyl pentane. Okay? For this one, the longest chain is 1, 2, 3, 4. So 2, 3, dimethyl butane. 2, 3, dimethyl butane. For this one, the longest chain is 1, 2, 3, and 4. You can number the carbon atom from this side. If you number it from this side, you see 1, 2, 3, and 4, right? So in this side, the sum of locants is what? 2 plus 3 plus 3. Because we have third position, we have 2 methyl groups, so 3 plus 3, that is 8. If you count from this side, so 2 plus 2 plus 3, that will be 7. So the correct one will be what? Correct one will be the white. Okay, this is not correct. Right? Okay. So name is what? At second position we have methyl, and 3 we have chloro. So first we'll write chloro in alphabetical sequence, right? So 3 chloro. Chaitanya, what happened? 3 chloro. 2,2 dimethyl butane.
No, I know. But green fish. Should we go in the order of which we're writing?
No, alphabetical. No, alphabetical, right? Emotions are not going to happen again. Dil nahi laga. Bolo.
Okay. Wait, sir, also, what do we usually take the functional
group
in the longest?
If functional is there, then we'll discuss that also.
Sir, Cl is not functional group.
Cl is a functional group. Cl is a functional group. But we'll follow the sum of locants rule here. It is not that the priority of Cl is very low. It comes down, very down. It is lesser, it has lesser priority than alkene or alkyne. We'll discuss that later, functional group. Okay. Now in this one, the longest chain is? We'll start from this side, right? Numbering 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. What is the name? 2-methylpentane. For this it is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. What is the name?
Sir, you get 6, sir.
1, 2, 3, 4,
5, 6. 6, sir.
Where?
Sir, it's okay. It looks
like exactly. So, start on this side, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 3,3 dimethyl hexane. Sir, 3,3 dimethyl hexane. What about this one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ethyl first and then methyl, right? So it is 3,4 dimethyl. Okay. One note you write down here. Write down di, tri, tetra. Di, tri, tetra are not considered in alphabetical sequence. Are not considered in alphabetical sequence. Di, tri, tetra are not considered in alphabetical sequence. Wait. Not considered in alphabetical sequence. If the substituents is not complex. If the substituents is not complex. Huh, tell me, Rujit.
So let's say like for the third one. 2,3-dimethylbutane. Why is it wrong to write 2,3-methylbutane?
2,3-methylbutane.
Because you will put dimethyl only when the same carbon atom has two of it.
See, 2,3 when you write, it means 2-methyl group are present. Right? So for 2-methyl group, you have to write down dimethyl. Right? See, what can I say? If you say that why not 2,3-methyl? Because we have 2-methyl groups, you have to mention in the name that there are 2-methyl groups present. But you can also say, sir, 2,3 if you write, it means there are 2-methyl groups present on second and third carbon. But we take this tetra term, it actually signifies the number of methyl groups present in the molecule. So 2,3-methyl you cannot write. 2,3 dimethyl you have to write.
If there are
2 methyls
on each of them, then how
will
you write?
2 methyl on each of them.
Yeah.
Then we'll write like this.
2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2,2
3, 3 tetramethyl. 2, 2 3, 3 tetramethyl. Okay. So this di, tri, tetratrum, we do not consider this into alphabetical sequence if the substituents is not complex.